Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Experience Hall. My name is Shani Obertai and I'm hosting this very stage. Right now we would like to talk about Hamburg. In Hamburg, at Mittelweg, that's a tiny little street, Mittelweg, there's a very special house called the Connected House. It's a different house. It's very connected. Everything is connected to the web. You can open the door with your smartphone, things like that. And before we start talking about that and these issues of the connected world, we'd like to show you a little clip so that we all got up to speed. Mats up.
Das ist die intelligenteste Tür der Welt, weil sie nicht liefern, haben wir die selber erfunden und ich mache es dann einfach mal mit meinem Telefon einfach auf. Denn dieses Telefon ist die Remote Control zu unserem ganzen Leben und insbesondere hier zu diesen ganzen Wohnungen. So, dann haben wir hier jetzt die Master Suite, das ist die größte Wohnung mit 260 Quadratmetern. Wir sind nett über drei Ebenen, mit dieser Dachterrasse mit dem Blick über Hamburg. Die Wohnung ist dann komplett ausgestattet mit allem, was das Smart Home irgendwie begehrt. Von einem bisschen großen 75 Zoll Bildschirm von Samsung, der die ganzen Smart Things so was ich mir da Google On hat, die Butler, Apple TV und viele der Sachen schon mal. Entweder über Sprache, in Form von Siri-Licht an, oder dass wir einfach mit den einzelnen Apps hier kommunizieren und jetzt einfach mal, machen wir jetzt mal nicht Polarlicht, sondern wir wollen jetzt einfach mal Kirschblüte haben. Aktivieren das und schon ist dann die Lampe, die im Tageslicht natürlich nicht so auffällt, aber wunderschön Kirschblüte und aktiv. Oben ausgehen. Und schon fährt das große Schiebe. Ein Feature von der Firma Dornbach wollten wir unbedingt haben, das wir uns jetzt entwickelt haben, und zwar. Ich fahre nach Hause und ich möchte, dass das Badewasser schon eingelaufen ist und die Wohnung nicht komplett überflutet ist. Dazu haben sie ein Produkt entwickelt, Smart Water. Das haben wir hier als erster jeweils verbaut. Und dann machen wir uns einfach mal die Badewasser. Ja. Der Rest ist jetzt 10% voll und die geht dann bei 100% dann auch aus. Das ist nicht überlaufen, aber das stoppen wir einfach hier schon mal. Ja, und in einem Smartphone ist es natürlich so, dass irgendwelche Technik auch stehen muss. Die Software ist alles in der Cloud, aber Hardware gibt es natürlich auch. Insofern haben wir hier diesen Onboard Switch Patchfeld, die Steuerung für die Bluetooth-Boden, alles im Combinimo, Smart Meters everywhere, Glasfaser von der Telekom, die Mediengeräte, Lamcom, ein bisschen größeren Schaltschrank, das ist nur für die Wohnung. Noch so mit dem einen oder anderen On-Hub, der hier noch so rumsteht. Das sind Räume, die einfach voraussetzen, dass die Infrastruktur da ist. Die Neuerungen, ob das jetzt Siri ist oder ob es andere Sachen sind, kommt halt über Software. Das heißt, das ist zumindest mal ein Haus, das sich über die Software weiterentwickelt. Und das für jeden, der ein Smartphone bedienen kann.
Ladies and gentlemen, and now we'd like to talk about the new life in the connected world. Please welcome Lars Hinrichs, founder and CEO of Cinco Capital. Hi, Lars. And we have more to come. Please welcome Christine Peitsch, head of data and science of IoT predictive maintenance from SAP. Come on.
Very soon, yeah. Billions of connected things, connecting billions of people, will generate trillions of terabytes of data. How can you transform your business with the Internet of Things? The answer is simple. SAP offers the most comprehensive portfolio of Internet of Things solutions from core to the edge of the network. Connect anything to your business to enable intelligence at the edge of the network and automate decision making. With the world's leading cloud-based IoT platform, enable in-memory computing, predictive analytics, spatial analytics, geolocation, telematics, and more. connect anything to transactional and analytical business data. Transform your core business processes to achieve operational excellence. Connect anything to the world's largest business network. And reimagine your business with new revenue models, new products and services. The only company that makes running the Internet of Things simple, SAP.
And here she is. Please welcome Christine Beisser, Head of Data Science and IoT of SAP. Here she is. And we have one more chair for a very great gentleman. He is from Procter & Gamble, Hans-Jörg Reich, Assistant Director of Research and Development. Hans-Jörg. All right. Let's get into it. You know, the connected house, Lars, you know, when you build it, it was there. If you would do it again, what would you change now?
A lot.
Like what?
I think I came by accident to the idea of a smart home. Actually, I just had a liquidity event some years ago, and I wanted to buy some real estate as asset allocation. Mm-hmm. And from this, and a lot of time, there comes the idea of building a smart home. So it became a prototype, and from a prototype, if it works, and the first tenants are moving in by end of this month, then maybe it's a product, we can scale it, and then I'm back in the internet world.
I got it. Hans-Jörg, what things does a house definitely need in order to be smart?
I think besides the one Lars has shown in his house, I think definitely a smart mirror. When we think about consumer products from P&G, our products are about everyday life, caring about the body and about the house. For example, a smart mirror. And then the smart consumer products on top, they make a great ecosystem.
Christine, the smart home is producing tons of data. You know, how can one manage so much data? Useful.
Yeah, here I think we need really more intelligence. Mm-hmm. That means machine learning, data science, which is a hot topic currently, and which is not used very much currently. So I also have a new house with a KNX system, an old-fashioned smart home system, and it doesn't have any real intelligence. So no machine learning, artificial intelligence, nothing. And I think that's what we need. Mm-hmm. More machine learning so that we can extract insights from this large amount of data.
Let me.
You mentioned just an interesting word, which is KNX.
Yes.
So KNX is like the used to be standard, or if you now go to an electrician, he would definitely sell you a KNX home. But for KNX, you need cables, and everything is expensive. You're tied to one vendor. And since we're all living online, we know what the everything protocol is, which is IP, the Internet mm-hmm. Protocol. So I really had the idea to build everything on IP.
Everything.
Everything. Everything is connected to the net. Everything. It's a house in the cloud.
Okay, let me play Advocatus Diaboli. You know, I'm living in a nice home. You know, it's nice, it's warm, it's cozy. Why do I need that? What's good for, what's in it for me?
I call it instant comfort. And let me give you some examples. I wanted to drive, and this is not possible, this scenario. So I drive with my Tesla into the garage, which is by far the largest e-charging station in Germany so far.
In your house?
In my house, so still on the phone, you go through the basement, still on the phone, you go to the elevator, still on your phone, and suddenly you have Wi-Fi, everything is connected. You open, you come to your door, the door is connected via Bluetooth LE, the door opens, all still on the phone. Mm-hmm. So it's really about making the life easier with things which are not possible. Or if you're living in the third floor, you open the door, the elevator comes immediately. Mm. If you ring on the doorbell, the light guides you to one of the flats. So it's about assistance. It's not about you taking away control. It's about just making things happen instead of doing something. Mm-hmm.
In order to have such a home, you have to put things in it which are smart. Procter & Gamble, what kind of products do you offer which would help me live in his house?
Yeah, we really look into intelligent and smart products that help in the everyday life, in the morning, in the evening, and throughout the day. And here are just some of our examples to create new experiences. One is, for example, a Febreze scent system, which is connected to a Nest thermostat. And by this ecosystem, it knows when you are in the house. It can do a freshness boost, for example, in the rooms you are actually in. Second is skin, caring about your body and the face. Smart machine learnings enable nowadays to really analyze your skin, provide good advice on which product to use in certain areas to just make a great experience. And look and feel in the end, and the self-esteem. And in oral care, we have launched a Bluetooth-connected toothbrush 2 years ago and now really upgraded it. And this is about taking care about your health, and it starts with the mouth, because a healthy mouth is the gateway to the body. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of scientific evidence that you need to get a healthy mouth for a healthy body.
I agree with
and
that.
And smart products can help there.
But I'm agree with a healthy mouth and all that stuff, but a smart toothbrush? Be a little bit more specific.
Let's do an experiment, and I like to ask my colleague Stefan Fögeding to come on stage, because despite IoT, it's not possible to brush and speak at the same time. what you see here is basically a typical right hand or brushing the teeth. And what's happening is that it's totally easy to brush in the left, and people take care about the front side, but ergonomically it's, for example, more difficult to get to the right side. And
really?
So people don't
really?
Brush equally. People simply don't brush equally, they miss zones and areas. In addition, they don't brush typically for the right time, and they often press too hard, which over the long term can cause some damage.
I didn't know that.
So what we have developed is now a system called Genius and Position Detection, which connects the power toothbrush with a smartphone. There's a MEMS sensor in. There's a MEMS sensor, like what you know from a Wii, a gaming console, in the handle. And I think we can put up the screen demo, guys, to... Yeah, exactly. And then there's a camera in... Maybe, Stefan, we move to the next one, to position detection. So what's happening is that you position yourself in a certain area in front of a smartphone. Once he is right, get ready to go and brush the teeth. And the system, overflow. And the system is then really designed. What you see here are six segments, which basically represent the front, the upper, lower right, and upper and lower left. And then you can brush with a kind of gamification feedback, instant real-time feedback.
Wow.
And this is only possible through IoT and smart products, because otherwise the problem is you simply don't know where you brush, right? And you always brush the same routine and you miss the same spot. So this brush now knows where you brush, coaches you to never miss a spot, and to guide you to the perfect oral health. If he's now pressing too hard, he gets a feedback, reduce the pressure. And what we hear from dentists is, for example, that in the modern world, they think people are pressing even harder than in the past because you are more stressed. So you put that on your toothbrush and in the end to the gums. And so now he has already done a really good job brushing away two areas. And if we now move to the next screen and we just stop the session, then we get actually to an analysis and tracking of the activities. If he had brushed for more than 2 minutes, a smiley reward comes up, and this is really motivating. We know that from consumers. You're motivated for a job, and toothbrushing is typically more a chore than a delight, and this is also bringing a fun and motivating aspects to toothbrushing.
Do you actually do that?
Yes. Yes, sure. And many people around the world, this is not a gadget or a joke. This is really a serious mass product, and it's sold globally. And it's applied globally and really to the benefit. So in the end, it also tracks the data of your past half year of brushing. The data is on the phone, but you can take it then to the dentist and really talk with the dentist. Dentist can even set certain specific reminders while you brush. So if you always miss a certain area or have a sensitive one, the product smartly adapts to your needs.
I think it would be great for my kids. They are very competitive. They have two kids. Yes. And I think they would like to see that. Who is better in brushing teeth?
And you have 45 apartments in Hamburg. I have one 45.
And that's why we need a smart mirror, because think about, in the end, if houses are even smarter.
By the way, please give a big round of applause for our model who is actually brushing like a champion. Wow.
So if you can get exactly, sorry, to this slide. Now, when you think about the opportunity, if now the apartments in Hamburg and all over the world have a smart mirror, then this interaction can go even beyond toothbrushes to skincare, facial treatments, body care, and the bathroom can become a health hub or a center.
Absolutely. Yeah,
very smart.
Wow, cool. I'm impressed.
So a toothbrush is a starting point. But
I never thought about smart toothbrushes, I have to admit. But, you know, all this data, having all this data, handling all this data, what's the biggest advantage of this data, toothbrush, house, and all this stuff?
There are many. I think one is really security, which we talked behind the scenes. I think that's the main one, to really get a more secure house, to help to get that by collecting all the data, but also reliability. For instance, I'm in the area of predictive maintenance, so I want to have a house where my heating system, other technical systems are really reliable, and machine learning can help there, and the big data, to detect patterns and get alerted very early so that somebody comes before it fails and it gets fixed before it fails.
Mm-hmm. Is it saving energy? How about your house in Middelweg?
Absolutely, because my model is a flat fee, so it's like living as a service. And the more you do flat fee, the more you are in the business of energy saving. So I have a Blockheizkraftwerk, Eisspeicher, and since all the flats are connecting to the central heating system, and if the system knows there's someone right now in the apartment or not, I can just no longer hold 100% in advance. I can maybe just lower it down to 50 or 60%. My average guess so far with the systems I have is that I reduce my energy bill about minimum of 30%.
Wow, that's a lot. We are here in Germany. In Germany, data security, privacy is always a big issue. Everybody living in your apartments, you know, using your toothbrush, you know, is creating tons of data. How about data security? If my insurance company knows that I'm just brushing the left side and not the right side, which you just told me, maybe I should get a worse deal or something like that. So let's talk about data security and data privacy.
Okay, so data security and privacy is really top of mind. We have trusted brands, and this is why data privacy is so important. All the data that we store really remains on the smartphone, so it's under your control. There is now an option to share it with your own cloud so that you could connect in the cloud to a dentist, but it's all in the consumer's control. The core data is on the smartphone, and like I showed, you take it to the dentist. And there is no privacy data ever shared out of the app.
How about your data in your house?
We have 580 data points. We are collecting them in real time. It's in the contract so that we use the data to improve your life.
But that's what everybody says.
Come on, it's definitely more important or better in the cloud than on your local service. I had this kind of old smart home system, and this machine comes with admin as a username and password, and it's immediately connected to the net. So, and based on my history on Zing, we did password analysis on Zing, and the number one password was actually password. followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, followed by Quartz. So the main security issue is really between the chair and the table. And we definitely make it much more secure doing this with the most trusted brands on the web and the most trusted clouds, and connect the clouds to each other in a way which is secure. Sure, we all think of, oh, maybe data and terrible things happen, but actually the comfort you get is so much more than the friction you could have. I think everybody here in the room would be on Facebook, and you're definitely sharing much more data on Facebook than in a home.
Christina, you are head of data science at SAP, so you are the biggest brain in data on the actually on the stage. So help us about the data security issue. These guys, gentlemen, just talked, but you're a woman. You have to be serious.
So I agree with Lars. I think companies can care much more about the security than a private person can. So I'm sure I can't as well than SAP can. So I would really trust in it. Of course, I don't want to give my data to everybody. So I want to decide which service do I receive, is it valuable to me, and if so, yes, I give it. And trust in technology providers who have the possibility and need to really follow the regulations, the European data privacy and data protection regulations, SAP as well. So I'm sure that such professional companies will do that better than I can do.
Okay. Hans-Jörg, I have to come back to the toothbrush because it's fascinating. You know, if that helps me to be a better toothbrusher, you know, what about dentists? Don't they hate you?
No, actually not at all.
Why?
Because
you put them out of job.
A dentist does not really appreciate drilling and filling holes. So a dentist is most happy when a user has a healthy mouth and no caries, no missing teeth. And so we have developed the system in close partnership with dentists. They have been our partner actually designing and developing it. And they really like it. Why? Because it's a way to bring the dentist into the home of the consumer, coaching you between the dental visits, which are typically 6 to 9 or in some cases 12 months. They don't see you for an extended period of time. And so they see this really as a tool. They recommend it to patients. They even demonstrate it. We have a special tool to demonstrate it in the office as a way to improve the oral health through coaching and guidance on a proper brushing routine. They actually are our partner.
Demexco is a digital marketing conference. Let's talk a little bit about marketing, Christina. You know, the smart home data, can it be integrated in an intelligent campaign management?
Yes, I think you have a lot of advantages integrating data. For instance, you can look at the usage, what has been used in the house. You can look at how much heating, or maybe a better example, you look at a Thermomix, so you see what did you cook last weekend, what do you have in your fridge, if you have a video camera there. So you could use this data to recommend, for instance, new recipes. Using all this data. So that would be one scenario. So I'm quite sure that you can really target and personalize marketing much more with such data than you can do today.
Lars, what's your message to marketeers who are in this this crowd here? Why should they invest?
I'm not yet buying this argument that selling your data is great based on your home experience.
No? Why not?
I'm not so sure, but maybe in terms of marketing, I'm building this house now since 3 years, and so we gained 18 million of media contacts so far in print, with lots of TV coverage. We had over 3,000 people already visiting Apartamentum, which is not finished yet. I think this is the first part of marketing, but selling my toothbrush data, I'm not so convinced yet. But I think I want to have the next version where I put like a few hundred micro drones in my mouth and they're doing the work.
I think data is only one part. I think I'm in R&D, but all of those products are created in super close partnership with marketing. The true is to create an experience that is irresistible and better from what you can get without smart and intelligent products. Mm-hmm. And data is only one part in the end. I think the most important thing why people will use smart products is because they also enjoy the moment much more, because it's an interaction with a product. It's not simply the use, it's a real interaction. Mm-hmm. And you get feedback. You improve your habits and your life. And I think this is the turning key. Data supplements it, but it's not the only thing. Mm-hmm.
But you just said you're working closely together with marketing. The marketing guys, they would love the data, wouldn't they? What are you telling them?
Actually, we had not those discussions yet, no? Because our purpose so far has been to create a much better toothbrush and a much better experience. And yes, we like the data because the consumer can use the data, go to the dentist, talk about maybe overbrushing or not brushing enough, mm-hmm. right? And that is enhancing the dialogue mm-hmm. and the experience.
Christine, another a marketing question. You know, if do we still need TV commercials for a toothbrush like this? If we have all this data, all this fancy stuff with the app?
Yeah. So I actually don't watch TV, but
what?
But expect from this fact. Mm-hmm. My problem would be that I feel I don't have the freedom to choose. So the question is, can I trust in whatever? Yeah, is recommended to me. So that would be my question. So how do I know that, yeah, this is the right one for me? If I look at commercials or at websites or so, then I feel I have the freedom to decide. Mm-hmm. And the question is, how do we do it so that people have still the feeling that they are deciding about what they are using?
Mm-hmm. It's really about comfort. It's not about selling data, stuff like this. It's really about comfort. Mm-hmm. And I showed the example about the smart door. Isn't this great if you maybe break up a relationship and you can just delete the key? You don't have to get it back anymore. So
very practical. Very practical.
So this I feel like maybe the thing.
Just the last question for everybody. If you look to the future, like in 5 years, smart living, connected living, how do you think how we do that?
Definitely, the bathroom is going to be the health center. The bedroom is trying to use products and data to make me sleep better. And this kind of living space, so this kind of open kitchen, open dining room, open living room is something where we would like to live and hang out.
Christine?
I think we should make the whole thing more intelligent with integrating really machine learning so that we can get insights from the data. If not, the data is not useful.
Hans-Jörg?
I think it will be the future standard for everyday products in multiple touch points during the day to make better experiences and performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was our panel on the Connected House, Connected Living with Lars Hinrichs, Christiane Preisach and Hans-Jörg Rieck. Thank you very
Thank
much.
You.